It's very challenging to get to space and test in space. So we can do things at typically a very small scale, but we need simulations to take that data and scale it up to how we're actually going to deploy that.
So as we were working through the eVinci program, we realized that it could really move beyond just what we're doing here on Earth and move towards a number of new applications where there's growing interest from civil, commercial, and defense sectors on how we can apply clean, reliable, resilient, and safe power to areas that really haven't been done before, which is the space sector.
Putting a nuclear reactor on a rocket means we need to be very conscious about how to do that. So we end up needing to simulate that full process to make sure our design is safe enough that we don't, you know, endanger the public and are able to perform the mission. We do a ton of analysis and years in advance so that we're fully confident by the time we do it for the first time. We know exactly how the system's going to be performing.
There's certainly different issues that we have to evaluate. So as we go through these things, there's a whole new set of challenges that we're working on that really require specific and specialized software, and that's something that I think Ansys has certainly helped us work through.
The goals for Astro Vinci really is to enable space missions that are not available today because of limitations from either radioisotope power source, energy storage, or solar energy systems.
There's a number of new applications that it can enable, particularly if you use the example of the lunar surface. As we look to get there, develop and create a new potential living space and an exploration space, you're going to need power.
The South Pole is a very, very treacherous place on the moon. It barely sees the sun, it's very low off the horizon, and you're subjected to lunar nights. So you can appreciate surviving that environment for almost 2 weeks at that temperature is very, very hard for any conventional technology. To support the space and visions that we have for humanity, this product is going to be critical for those applications. So we're really excited to be able to offer that and offer that in a time frame that's realistic and achievable with the use of Ansys products and these simulation techniques that weren't possible in recent times.
It's exciting that we can take nuclear technologies really to that next frontier. We can open up new possibilities